What's up, YouTube? It is Friday and I have the day off, so you know what that means. I'm gonna mess with my car a bit. I mean, who wouldn't? So you've probably been following a little bit of the squeak stuff. That piece that I took out in the last video, I don't think it was the exact same squeak. I did hear additional stuff here. What I'm gonna do next, a lot of people have said, I'm gonna put that OEM sway bar in for a bit and see if the noise completely vanishes or not. I know the whole history and sway bars causes the most noises and everything. I'm not 100% convinced, but this will prove it one way or the other. So I'm gonna put the OEM sway bar back in and I'll reassemble everything. I'm probably gonna leave the spare out for the weight savings, honestly. I don't have a scale in here, but you know, I think I could tell a difference a little bit. And with my Noico down here, I'm gonna go ahead and Noico this trunk floor to keep even more noise out. I wanted to do that. It was either that or the underbody tray. And with that flimsy plastic and all wide open, I feel the Noico is gonna be better utilized right here instead, just to keep more of that resonance and muffler noise. The thicker the better. I know that is a thick piece, but you know, whatever, just make it a little better. I was going to think about some of this aluminum tape that I've had forever. I basically just wanted to use it up and just be done with it on some of the some intake pipe or something in here, but I don't think there's really a good spot with the stock intake. You know, there isn't just nice perfect round tubes. I probably won't mess with that. That's just a waste of time. But yeah, I am doing a sway bar swap. I'm not going to film the work. It's pretty basic. I do want to get the car straight and flat before I do my final tighten with the final install. But for now, it can be crooked and it can be on a slant. It doesn't matter because I'm just taking it off. Hey guys, it's been about 2 hours since the last clip. Believe it or not, all of that time has been working on this trim, getting it just right, making sure I had every little nut and every little button in place where it goes. Just in case anybody remembers in that last little clip on a previous video about that missing snap that I had, that extra snap, it went on this piece and there's a little tab that comes out of this at the metal back here. And that push pin goes in there. So anyway, I did get it nice and tight everywhere. It's a weird clip right there, but I've looked at it. I may look at it one more time, but that's an easy piece right there. The sill, everything's tight. And you can see with just smallish jiggling, I do not get noise. None of that stuff that this had before in that dark video, same piece I was touching and all that squeaking. I worked on all the clips, tightened them all up, made sure every clip was snapped in. That's why it took me almost 2 hours to get this little area back here just perfect, because I had to keep taking it apart again and again just for like a missing clip or a little metal clip that fell off and fell down, you know, to the bottom. And the rear sway is back to stock. There's the new speed, the red new speed right there. So I'll give that a shot too. Got that all tight. I'm just gonna close up the trunk a little bit more and then I'll be back. All right guys, just finishing up with the little sound deaden product project. I just had a few pieces left and I just like to use stuff, so I figured I'd put it under here. Of course, I didn't go overboard every square inch just to add weight to my car. And no, I'm not gonna tell a difference, I don't expect, with any of this, but that's just what I did. Got it into the creases. I haven't even used the roller yet, and I'll get it all fixed up, looking a little bit better. So sometimes I go a little overboard. So sue me. Look at that. Super sound deadening. No, I'm not trying to hide the squeak. That's impossible. Just making my car quiet as always. The car is all back together. Well, almost. I'll show you a couple things. Looking real good. I, of course, vacuumed out and took a nice opportunity there. Got, I think that's an aftermarket LED light. Oh, what if I don't pass inspection? Now they're tightening down. Oh no, I think there's a new police reform in Virginia starting January where they can't, well no, that's about not pulling you over for tint and stuff like that in Virginia. Oh well, never mind. So that's it. Let me get my tray. I really want to get all this back together. The last thing, I am moving the spare to the shed. There'll always be a couple guys who type a comment right now. Dude, what if you get a flat? You're gonna wish you had that spare. Well, not really. I get your point. You want to be extra careful. In every car that I have, I got a safety seal kit, and I keep everything I need to pull and plug a nail anytime I want. Now, and this is a brand new kit because the last kit I forgot to take out of the WRX right down here, and some lucky person got a brand new kit under their, or the dealer probably took it, more like, or the cleaner, the detailer kid probably took it for himself. So yeah, in a nutshell, no, I'm not gonna run my spare. That means I'm not gonna run this stuff, but you know, I'll probably put this tool in the glove right now before I forget. As if I ever do need to, you know, have someone help me or whatever, I do want the correct tool, as it's much faster. Just hook and grab, instead of using picks and everything, scratching up your wheels, which I used to do until I decided that the OEM tool was far superior. All right, the very last thing, I'm gonna first collect all these jack parts into a little bundle, probably put it in the spare tire, bring that to the shed. I don't have a whole lot of room, but luckily I reorganized the shed. I certainly don't wanna keep that spare in here. And then I gotta lock down my seats, the four back seat points, where you can see those exposed white bars down there. We're gonna cover those up and we're all done. I can't wait to cruise this car. Not that it's anything different. I've been loving this car, as I said, I think in the last video maybe. It's so fun now. It's my toy. Finally, it's kind of become what I wanted it to be. And it's getting better and better, aside from the squeaks. Like fine wine, it grows whinier with age. I just made that up. Yeah. So that's it, guys. The main thing is I'm going to be listening for that noise again. If it's still there, whatever. You know, that sucks. That's life. That's called, you know, diagnosing your car for most people. And if it's gone, if it was that sway bar, shit, I mean, I'll be as happy as the next guy. The only difference I can think of is probably the poly bushings for the new speed sway. Oh, I touched it. And these factories are rubber. I don't honestly think that's even the point at which the noise was coming from, the frame bushing, but I just wanted to get the stock sway in there just for a test to see if it changes anything or not. And I do eventually want to get the Bilstein, those yellow and light blue shocks, the B somethings maybe, B5s, B6s. Not coils, none of that fancy stuff. I don't do that. Just shocks. I've always liked the Bilstein monotubes over the Kony twin tube. My favorite is, believe it or not, the KYBs, which is kind of old school. I'm from the 80s. And I love the five-way KYB adjustables where you'd have a dial on top, 1 through 5, adjust the perfect dampening. But KYB doesn't make nearly as much stuff for the odd cars as I think most of the other places do. I don't think you'd find adjustable KYBs, which are their AGX line, which I had on my 2005 WRX, I believe. But I'm gonna see eventually. So bottom line, if the squeak is still there, you know, I'll replace the shocks. I've checked everything in the entire corner. Maybe it's a shock, I don't know. Or maybe it's gone. All right, guys, see you later.